In the short video, I'm going to teach you process, state, events, and clocks. So this is the first topic in fourth unit. So teach this, I consider distributed system as a collection of n process. Or I can say it as a set of process. So I write in this another way. I write distributed system in another way. So that is distributed system equal to a set of process, or otherwise I name the set as set 1, is equal to P1, P2, P3. And up to Pn. There is one important property here. Each process Pi is execute on a single processor. And second property, it never shares memory with other processors. So these are all the two important properties. Now, so a distributed system is a set of process. So each process Pi have its own states, that is Si. So what is mean by a state in general? It is very simple. A state is nothing but the values of all variables within that particular process. So I can write it as a process state is nothing but values of all variables within it. So this is the simple way I can explain the state of the process. Now, each process executes, it takes a series of action of which either it is a message send operation or a receive operation or the operation that changes its state. So changing the state is nothing but changing the values present in it. So totally there are two operations or two action that a process does when it execute. So a Pi does two operations or actions. So the first action is send or receive operation, or otherwise I can call it as communication operation. The next operation is, so this is my first operation, and second operation is the operation that changes state of the process, that is changing the values of all the variables present in it. Now the important thing is I need to capture or I need to create an event for this particular process. So what is an event? So I already explained the process as it executes, it takes a series of action, each of which is either a send or receive operation or changing of state of the process. So the event is defined as, it's a simple way, event is defined as occurrence of single action. So the occurrence of single action as the process executes is called as event. It may be either a send operation or a receive operation or the operation that changes the values of variables in that corresponding to that particular process. So this is called an event. So as a process executes, it creates multiple events. So I need to store this event in total ordering technique. So total ordering is represented by using a special symbol, this operator. So this is used to represent the total ordering. So what is total ordering? It is nothing but storing this events in a proper order in this way: E1, E2, E3 and up to EN. So that is what it says. It's in a very simple way, this E1 is always happened before E2, and E2 is always happened before E3, and E3 is always happened before EN. So you need to store this event in this particular total ordering scheme. This can be represented using this symbol, this arrow, right-sided arrow, that is used to refer this total ordering. I can call this set as history. So the history of PI, the history of a process, one process PI, is nothing but, I can say it as HI to represent, or I can write HI to represent the history of P1. So this E1, E2, E3, all these are different events that occurred at the time of running the process. So the process P1 created this many events. So how it created this many events? The process at the time of running, it is going to perform this many actions, and each and every action is called as events. And I am going to order these events in total ordering scheme. So this is the event. Now, why I need a clock? What is the use of this clock? So I know the history P1 is nothing but the event that has already happened in this particular process. Now I need to timestamp this each and every event. In order to timestamp this each and every event, I need a clock. The clock, there are two types of clock that is used in computer. So what is the first clock? That is a hardware clock. This is the first clock, and the second clock is software clock that is based on this hardware clock. This hardware clock is based on oscillator, a special device that operates at a specific frequency, and that is used to capture the time. And the software clock, this is captured using the hardware clock value. So the software clock, it is very simple. The software clock is captured, or it is calculated, by using the special device called the electronic device called oscillator, and that counts oscillation occurring in a crystal at a set of definite frequency. And we typically divide this count and store the result in a counter register. And this counter register value is also called as our hardware clock value. And I can represent this as HI of T. And based on this HI of T, by scaling it, by scaling this hardware clock and adding some offset value, I can get the software clock. That is my CI of T. So this is the CI of T is my software clock. And I can represent this CI of T as alpha. I am not able to use the symbol alpha here because I am using a normal notepad. So I simply type alpha. I am going to scale it, right? The scaling operation is mentioned here as alpha with HI of T. Then I am going to add the offset value. So I am going to use the plus symbol here, and I am going to use the beta to represent that particular value. So here I am going to scale up to some value, plus I am going to add that offset value to the original hardware clock to create the software clock. So why I am doing this operation? I am doing this operation to create a standard, or I am trying to create the accuracy in the clock value. So this is the purpose of this software clock. So the hardware clock that is based on oscillator, and I am going to add, or I am going to scale it, and I am going to add an offset value for creating an accurate clock, and that is called as my software clock. Now What are all the problems in this clock? The first problem is skew. So if I take a reading of this clock now, this will display now it is 4 o'clock. And if I take a reading from this particular clock, the time is 4:05. Now the difference is 5 minutes. The difference is called as skew, clock skew. The difference between the reading of any two clocks is called as clock skew. And what is the next problem? That is clock drift. The crystal based clock count time at different rates. So each and every oscillator has a different frequency. So this rate is called as the drift rate. It is usually used to measure the change in the offset per unit of time. So what is this? It is nothing but each and every oscillator works, or each and every oscillator working mode is affected by different parameters. The different parameters are the temperature, then the operating condition. So each and every parameter affects its oscillations, and that rate is called as the drift rate. That is a clock drift. So these are all the two problems that comes in computer clock. And normally this problem is avoided with the help of clock synchronization, and I will teach that in the next video.